So hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to add a new column to existing table in SQL. So I'm using mysql workbench to show you a demo. So currently I have created a database named latest, and just give use latest and hit run. You will be using our database. So let's get started by creating a table. So first demo, I will just create a table with one column. Okay, so for create a table, create table. I will table it as new tab, something table name, new tab. Create table new tab, and let's have roll number as one of the values. So roll number is going to be integer. Okay, and let's create a table. Okay, zoom out a bit and run it. So as you can see here, we have got a green tick. That means our table has been created. So to display the table, select asterisk from table. So you select asterisk from table, that is our table name, that's new tab. Okay, select it and run it. So it has only odd number, it doesn't have any value. So let's insert some values. Okay, so insert into new tab values. Since it has only one column, let's insert one. Run it, and two. And three. So if we check it now, so we will have having roll number, and we have three values over here. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's very fine. So now what we are going to do is we are going to add a new column. Okay, so for adding that, it's a very simple code. We will be using alter table over here statement. So it's going to be alter table, and the name of our table, that is new tab, and add. Okay, just basic. So add column. So you need to use the column statement or keyword column, and our column name. So I will keep the column name as name. Okay, this is our column name. Okay, column is a keyword and name is our column name, and data type of our name. So I'm going to put varchar some 10. Okay, so once again I will explain: alter table keyword, our table name, add column keyword, our column name, that is a new column that is to be added, and its data type to be added. So just select this, hit run, and I think we are getting a green tick. We'll clear this first. Okay, and now if you display our table over here, so just select it, and if you just display it, so as you can see here, we are having our roll number, but our column, okay, as we have seen, our new column has been added name, but it has null because we haven't inserted any values over there, but our roll number has three values. Okay, so for inserting values, if you try this, okay, many of you have done by using trying this. If you try insert into new tab values, and if you just put null over here and comma, and if you add some, enter some name, okay, for corresponding to our next column. So first I will type Kumar something, a name, and if you just now copy this, and if you run it, your code will work because it's right, absolutely right. But what will happen is that as there were three rows, okay, this value will be added as the fourth row. Okay, it won't be added as null, so it will be added as a fourth row, and this time the fourth row of R number will be null, and the fourth row of name will have some value. So I will just show it. Okay, so as you can see here, our fourth row of R number is null, and first three is null in name, but our fourth row has value. So how to insert a value in this? It's very simple, by using update method. Okay, so it's going to be, just get a new line. Okay, so it's going to be update table name, that is new tab, set. Okay, this you set the value, and we are going to set it in the column. Okay, or column name. Column name equal to, what's the first name that we are going to, let me give it as John. So John is going to be our first value. Okay, that is roll number one, John, and where R number, this is a reference. Okay, R number equal to one. So what we are doing is that we are just setting the value of our column, first row of our column as John, and by using reference as R number equal to one. So if I just run it and select from new tab, our first row of our name column will be John. So as you can see here, the null has gone and our value has been added over here. As you can see this, and if you just, now it's pretty simple. If you want to add And the second name in for second roll number, just go here, change this as R number 2 and enter your specific name and run it again. So like this way you can add values to your new column. So that's it for this video, and hope you liked it. Do check my other videos of my channel. I've done tutorials C, C++, Java, etc. And check my other videos and subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.